Hey guys, it's Gary with Upton Bass. It's another one of those early mornings before the guys show up. And I just wanted to show you our new model, the Mittenwald Bass. And here I have an old, probably late 1800s Mittenwald that who knows what's been done to it. Something that we, I think, took on trade maybe, oh God, 6, 7, 8 years ago. Anywho, that instrument was sort of the inspiration for what is this new model. I had a customer come in, a customer by the name of Paul, we'll leave out his last name, and he really, really, really liked the Brescian, but he said, Gary, I like a gamba, I love a gamba bass, gamba corners, obviously, and I said, well, you know, what's a big bass that has nice deep ribs, a nice angled cant to the back, and also, you know, a fairly puffy arch on the top, not as puffy as the Brescian model. The arch is definitely not as tall. When I refer to the arch, I'm referring to essentially how tall it is between the top of the rib and essentially where the bridge sits. But anyway, Paul was the inspiration essentially for this new model. And so we completely redid the mold from the Bohemian model, even though the Czech and the Bohemian, the Czech Bohemian stuff and the Mittenwald stuff isn't all that far apart. I think the Mittenwald, we've really nailed it all the way. Let me show you a few things. Hopefully you can see the outside linings in these shots. The idea here is, again, we already put our linings on the inside of the bases, we always have, but to be authentic to the Mittenwald school, we like the outside lined, you know, ribs. This instrument is set up with Tomastic bel cantos. It is very much set up for an orchestral player. Nice round bridge, nice round board. Really just to nail it, so it's got a really nice under the bow tone. This is a hybrid. I'm not gonna say only a hybrid, but it is only a hybrid. Loving to do this model, obviously, out of Fancy Woods. We have one that we'll be making for the ISB in June. If you don't know what the ISB is, I'm gonna do a video on what the ISB is. I hope that helps people go to the ISB. I'm not gonna tell you too much. You're gonna say, what the heck is he talking about, ISB? Anyhow, a lot of you know, some of you don't. But we will have a solid wood, more amber colored one that we'll just be showing folks at the ISB. That will be a fun instrument just to kind of show what a solid wood version of this instrument sounds like. Still a flat back, still, you know, plain Jane maple back and sides, again, staying authentic to the school. Just like the ebony half-peg tuners. I'm trying to be a bit more specifically accurate to the schools of the making that we've been doing. We've had customers want these on, say, the Gary Carr bass, or, and again, that's a pattern we've developed with Gary and with the work of Jim Hamm. And there's nothing wrong with putting ebony hat pegs on there. That's more of just a, oh, I'd like those, check that box. On the Mittenwald, you have to. It's authentic. Anyhow, let's play this bass. It's a very dark pizzicato sound. Again, I'll remind you, it's for an orchestral player. That's really what this bass has been made and set up for. Despite all that, I do think the flat back and the way the bass is made, it's still helping it project fairly well with this very dark. Cantos are kind of gut-like, and there's so many strings that we've spoken about, and they sound like guts, and it's just been advertised for years now, and if it's got steel on it, it generally doesn't sound like gut. But what I mean, when I'm talking about this orchestral set that actually sounds like gut, and I think a lot of those guys that really want that vintage sound, you don't have that front end that you get out of a spire core.
Thank you.
guys can hear, I mean, for a hybrid, this thing is killing. It sounds a lot better than a lot of carved basses you play. One of the ideas behind a flatback hybrid is that most flatbacks have braces on them, don't they? So even if you have a solid wood flatback, you're still bracing it. And our mentality is, of course there's a difference. You know, like the Copenhagen bass that we brought for the Tone Award, that was a solid wood flatback. But still here with a hybrid flatback, I don't think the difference is as immense. We can wood the back a little bit lighter when we're laying up the veneer process. And we can also obviously then brace the instrument and have something that is strong, durable, inexpensive, because you're not buying pieces of solid wood, and it has that sound that's bringing you closer to a real bass, if we can say. This instrument is just a nice, elegant gamba, patterned right after this one right here. Obviously, one of these guys is set up varnished and has an end pin in it, but I just wanted to hold them side by side so you could get a look at the general look and feel that we've tried to create as a new Upton bass versus an old 1800s instrument. I hope you get it. I hope you feel it. This guy needs a lot of work over here on the right, my right. Chris tried to catch the varnish in the back on this bass, kind of have it inspire this. Obviously an Upton bass scroll, an Upton bass in general, but inspired by the Mittenwald school. Hope you like it, and call me or email us with any questions. Thanks, guys.